Hi everyone! In the last video, we learned how to select one state at a time. In this video, we will learn how to select multiple states at a time. To demonstrate multi-state selection, I will reuse the get controller component again. So let's go back to the component. And we see here we have two states. Both of them are functions, which won't be changed in the component. And in the last video, we just learned how to extend an auto selector. And we use use to select the increase big cats function, but it means only one state at a time. Now in this video, we will learn how to select multiple states at a time. So I will copy the code from my notes here. So here, comment out here. So we can write code in this way. Let's take a look at the code. Inside the useCat store, here is the callback function, but this time we return an object which contains the two states. And this is very important. In the second argument, shallow, which is the equality function, you can import it from Zustand shallow, and you need to use the bracket to export the shallow function. We will talk about the shallow function later. Now let's take a look at the result. So refresh, and now we add a big cat, add small cats, all correct. And here, the mass render didn't change. That means the component didn't render correct. So now let's take a look. What if we remove the shallow? Go back to the code, refresh, and then now we add a big cat, add a small cat. We see here the mass random changed every time. That means the component is re-rendered, although there were no state changes inside the cat controller. So it's very important, don't forget to write the shallow. So let's go back and take a look. Add big cats, add small cats. So maybe you will ask why this happened. Because the returned value is an object, and it is recreated every time. So if you don't have a shallow function, then the program will consider every time it returned a new object, which means the states are all changed, so it will be rendered. I also want to mention, if your states are complicated, you can write your own comparison function. And another thing is, you can actually also return an array. So how to do that? I just comment it out and put the code here. And here we see we return the two states directly in an array. And here should also an array. Okay, this is how to select multi-states at one time. In the next video, we will talk about the DevTools.